Good morning, everybody. Today is, oh my gosh, I'm so, did you just see that? Oh my gosh, there's so many pigeons. All right, take two, before I was so rudely interrupted by the pigeons. It is such a beautiful day in the city. Joe and I are taking a nice, very long walk to the Ossington area, mainly to visit 135 Ossington, and then we have a few errands to run, but oh, I feel like we've like gone over a hump because now we're finally able to enjoy this weather, and I feel like our mood and just the overall feeling and mood has been boosted in the city. So yeah, I'm excited to take you guys along for the ride. I see you from across the room. I don't know what to say to you. Don't think I can avoid you all night. I can't stand this place no more, but I'm still here. Don't know what for. You know that I've been waiting all night. I can't get used to letting you go. I hope you know that I don't wanna go nowhere, cause I need you in my life. Oh, I need you by my side, yeah. We can go somewhere to be alone on our own. If you want, I can show you just how much I need you in my life. So we are in yet another garden center plant store because I am making contingency plans. We've arrived at that point where I think I need some backup. We just got home, we changed, and we put lunch, or we're cooking lunch, and I thought we'd just show you what we picked up on our 2.5 hour walk this morning. The first item, my contingency plan, I decided just to buy one because my basil plants ain't doing so hot right now, even though 2 weeks ago I planted them. I don't know if they'll make it, so here we are. We have one that's kind of just starting to grow out their true leaf, and so I feel like they've got a chance to survive. And then the other thing, we went to Mountain Equipment Co-op because I wanted to buy a helmet. Now that we're living downtown, I feel like I should really embrace the downtown life and living, and that includes biking as a form of commute. So I ordered this online for pickup, and so this is what it looks like. Real attractive, y'all. I think it should fit my head pretty decently. Oh, it's nice. Oh, it's a really good fit. Ow, what is this? Oh, and then, nice. How do I look?
Like a biker.
It looks so wild right now with my hair peeping out from all angles. So for reference, my head size is around 58. My head circumference is around 58 centimeters. So I ordered this one from Smith, and it was about $100 plus tax. And yeah, this is a medium in black, and it fits. So I'm excited to try this out very soon. Okay, we're out to get dinner. I've been craving Korean fried chicken the entire week, and so that's what I'm going to get right now. here is our dinner. I ordered from the fry. So this is boneless chicken with spicy sauce. Just open this up. Oh, it comes with a can of Coke. I didn't even know. And then this is the spicy rice cake. So this is what I ordered. And then Joe here ordered some Indian food. Let me show everybody. So I think one of them is chaat, which is Indian. I'm saying that wrong for sure, but it's a type of Indian street food. And then Joe also ordered a palak paneer. And then we made our own rice.
Wow, what an interesting package. Wow, this is the first time I've ever ordered the fry pickup. Looks very beautiful.
Is it only for opening the package? Not for like...
I think you can use the other side too.
That's nice. Like if you want to eat in your car, you almost need
a way to open up the car.
Mm. Yeah. I mean, your hands are already dirty, just fish it up. Maybe they're actually meant for it to be like a key thing.
Oh yeah. COVID. This is what I'm going to use to poke the elevator open. Whoa.
It's huge. So you got all this for one person?
Yeah.
Eating.
Ooh, spicy chicken. These are the bikes. I'm just gonna choose one. I'm gonna take it and we're gonna go. All right. Undocking and redocking a bike for my second 30-minute trip. But now we're gonna head back up.
Some boys began to drink beer and whiskey. A few began to smoke marijuana.
I'm home now, but before I like wash off the bike grime and everything, I thought I would just share a little bit about my experience. My first experience trying the city bikes here in Toronto, and today was the perfect day for it. It was so clear. I went early enough that there wasn't a lot of traffic. I think whenever I think of biking in Toronto, it's like quite daunting, just because I feel like there's so many cars and people and other bikers that, you know, when we're out there, you feel like you're in danger. Like, we hear too many stories of people like getting hurt or getting run over by cars or getting swiped by cars. But yeah, I made it a point to wake up early to try it, and it was the best ride ever. There's an app that you can download where you pay for a pass and it comes in like three different plans or four different plans, and you just choose the one that's most appropriate for your use. I picked up a bike at one of the stations, and then I punched in a code that I got from my app. And if you don't have an app, that's okay. They have kiosks as well, so that you can purchase it while you're there. And then yeah, I just like checked my brakes, I checked the gears, I checked like the bell, and then I adjusted the seat before I actually like went on my ride. The city has quite a few roads blocked off right now, so that, you know, if you wanted to go out and be active, or I guess it's a way to encourage city folks to enjoy the outside a little bit more and find other ways to, you know, like stay active without being afraid of cars, which is what I mentioned just earlier. Yeah, I'm really looking forward to this being something that I can do throughout the summer, and I'll link some things that some resources down in the description box in case you wanted to look into it. But yeah, there's like such a huge network of these city bikes that you can just go from like different areas, different neighborhoods in Toronto. I think the only gripe I have with it is that it has this like 30 minute window or 30 minute trip limit, and so every 30 minutes you have to like you have to dock your bike and then undock a new one depending on your plan. And I guess that's like the only limitation, but other than that, would recommend. And I think there's gonna be a lot more biking content once I get a GoPro or something, or like I charge my GoPro, because it was Danger City. Okay, gonna wash up now.